Hello, in this presentation, I'm going to talk about our work on 3D annotated models of rosebush plants via X-ray imaging. This is a summary of the research paper we have published on plant methods, namely ROSEX and an annotated data set for evaluation of 3D plant organ segmentation methods. So we obtain X-ray volumetric images of rosebushes using an X-ray imaging device, and we obtain a three-dimensional function IXYZ, which is a measure of X-ray attenuation at each voxel located at XYZ coordinate. So the rosebush model is represented as X-ray data, and this X-ray data can be in a volumetric array, or we can convert it to a point cloud as seen in the middle, or we can obtain a triangular mesh model from this point cloud as seen in the right. So why are we processing this data? Because we want to develop 3D computer vision techniques or test 3D computer vision techniques for automatic part segmentation. So what is the objective of segmenting a 3D model into its parts? It's mainly we want to automate the measurement of plant traits. The plant traits corresponding to the branches can be the architectural structure or the location of branching points, or the stem height, or the estimation of the stem width, or the distances between internodes, or the estimation of branching angles. The traits related to the leaves can be the number of leaves, the leaf area, leaf length, or leaf inclination angle. So what we do, first we label the parts manually. We do this for two reasons. The first reason is to train machine learning methods, and the second reason is to evaluate the performance of automatic segmentation methods. So in our data set, we have 11 rosebush models with ground truth labels. These labels are obtained through manual annotation. We have the following labels: stem, leaf, flower bulk, flower parts, pot, tag, and background. The stem class includes all branches and petioles in the rosebush plant. In addition to this data, we tested some baseline methods for segmenting stems from the leaves. Most methods in the literature up to now are designed to separate leaves from branches. So the procedure is as follows. We first have the manual labeling. This manual labeling allows the computer vision systems to train their models. And after this training, using these trained models, the computer vision system can automatically segment leaves and stems from a new plant. We have tested four baseline methods on this data set. I'm going to give the details of each method in the coming slides. The first method is based on the Elastic software. This software basically extracts local features, for example, smoothed voxel intensity, edge filters, and texture descriptors. And these features are extracted from smoothed versions of the volumetric data. After the extraction of the local features, a random forest classifier is trained using the fully annotated data of one X-ray rod bush volume, and then the classification model is applied to other rod bush models to segment leaves and branches. For the second and third methods, we use PCA-based local features on point cloud data. So how do we extract these local features? For each point on the point cloud, we first define a neighborhood. Then we calculate the mean of the points in this neighborhood. And then we calculate the covariance matrix. And the eigenvalues of this covariance matrix indicate the local structure of the neighborhood of the point. So, for example, if the largest two eigenvalues are very close to each other and they are larger than the smallest eigenvalue, that means the neighborhood of the point has a planar structure, which makes the point more likely to be located on a leaf. When the largest eigenvalue is far larger from the second and third eigenvalue, that means we have a line-like structure in the neighborhood of the points, in the neighborhood of the point, which means that the point is more likely to be located on a branch. So for the method two, we define different neighborhoods to extract the eigenvalues. So this is a multi-scale method. We compute ratios of eigenvalues, and using these ratios, we form a feature vector for each point. And then we train these feature vectors using support vector machines using one rosebush as training data, and then apply the model to test on the other rosebush data. The third method is an unsupervised method. It's also based on these PCA-based local features. But here, we a conditional random field is introduced. So here for each point, two cost functions are defined. So the first cost function is the cost of classifying the point into a stem or leaf class. And this is a function of eigenvalues at that point. The other cost function is the cost of classifying two neighboring points into different classes. And this cost function is a function of curvature at points of these two neighboring points. So we classify the points in the point cloud data by minimizing this energy function using some optimization technique. The fourth method is based on deep learning. So what we do, we apply convolutional neural network to the volumetric data. Specifically, we use a 3D unit, which was originally introduced to segment medical images. So the architecture of the 3D unit is composed of convolutional layers followed by max pooling. And then these features are then upconvolved using interpolation to get the labels of each point on the volumetric data. So here are the results we obtained using the these four methods on our data set. We use recall and precision as evaluation measures. For example, recall for a leaf is equal to the number of leaf points correctly detected by the algorithm divided by the number of leaves in the ground truth. Precision is the ratio of the number of leaves correctly detected to the points detected as leaves by the algorithm. So if we see the results, we see that Elastic, which is based on extracting local features from the volumetric data, gives the best results both in terms of recall and precision. The local features with conditional random field also gives reasonable results and is followed by local features with support vector machine. The 3D unit gives the worst results because it gives a very low rate of precision for STEM. So we believe that this is because we don't have enough training data to fully train the 3D unit network. So here is an example of a 3D model segmented by these four methods. So the main reason Elastic is making errors is because it cannot classify petioles into branches because they seem very planar. The local features with SVM gives noisy isolated points. Results with local features and conditional random fields are more smooth, but here we can have an entire leaf if classified as a stem. And 3D unit was not able to classify the thick parts of the and the boundaries of the leaves as leaves, it rather classified them as branches. So as conclusions, we can say that the Elastic-based volumetric approach where we use a random forest classifier yielded the best performance. However, the other three baseline methods are open to further improvement. Of course, other state-of-the-art techniques can be evaluated on this data set. And this data set has the potential to be annotated with more advanced traits, such as the structure of the architecture. And it can be used as a benchmark for evaluating other automatic phenotyping methods that go beyond classifying plant points as leaves and stems. Thank you for listening.